A portion of this video, just about 10 minutes in, is sponsored by Toner. There I talk about this mic they sent me to be the guinea pig for these edits. Hey guys, Jason here, and welcome to my first How to Edit VoiceOver Audio video using Cakewalk. Compared to my past tutorials using Audacity, this one's going to be a lot smoother for y'all in the long run, since after you build out this plugin chain, you can apply it to new audio by just recording to the same project to get this effect instantly. And compared to installing plugins with Audacity, Cakewalk is a lot easier because you just put them in the right folder and there's no need to enable them from within the DAW. Oh, and I'm showing you the actual edits plus how to install the plugins today. So this is really everything you need to get started in one spot for free. Let's get into things. First, let's run through the actual edits. I started building out this plugin chain around the time I did my dorm room tour back in April, and I probably finalized it around the time I did my top-down shot tutorial in July. And so for the last several months, I've been consistently using these edits for just about everything, so feel free to listen to any of the past several videos I've done just to kind of feel out whether you like this effect. I do think the general consensus is that it is full, yet crispy, and also pretty professional sounding at the same time. So that's what we're going for today. The one place I'm not using this effect though is right now, because what you're listening to is raw audio that I'm going to add plugins onto to give you an example of the effect while also guiding you through this process. So first off, I'm going to drop Sonidus Gate onto the chain, which is a noise gate built into Cakewalk. You literally just got to find the little plugins tab over here, search for or just find Sonidus Gate, and then drop that over to the effects section of the audio track to get this guy going. The attack, hold, and release settings I got on here, plus the depth of negative infinity to completely cut out the audio in between words, is something you can definitely copy exactly to get a pretty standard effect. But that threshold is something you gotta tweak to make sure it's removing sounds in between words while also keeping your actual speech. Next, we're bringing in TDR Nova, everyone's favorite free dynamic EQ plugin. And the curve I got here is probably real familiar looking, going back to even my last Audacity editing tutorial using the Movo mic. However, it still sounds good to me, and I think it does a good job of doing those baseline, cut out the bad frequencies, and bump the good ones. Next, TDR Slick EQ is what we're putting on here next with its crazy simple interface and application. It's literally just here to let you tweak the sound to your liking. So for instance, you're probably using a different mic than me. Let's say you're not hearing enough crisp in the audio that you're getting so far. So all you gotta do is just bump that high-end gain knob higher than where I got it to get more crisp in your sound. Just remember not to go overboard. I've definitely had my days of boosting the bass too much because I thought it sounded cool at the time, or really cranking those highs. Remember not to do things to the extent that they would detract from the actual voice. VX64, just like Sonidus Gate, is built into Cakewalk, with the only difference being this guy is hidden upon first installation. It is pretty ridiculous you have to make this guy appear to be able to use it, but I will drop the form down below that has all the instructions you need. And here, we're literally just using the de-esser right here, everything else is off, to reduce those harsh S sounds in your voice. This does have other handy features for music though, so check out my more music-oriented content if you're interested in that. Real quick, as the next plugin of the chain, there's Era De-esser. This is the only paid plugin in the entire lineup, and I will say it's not even entirely necessary here. I have it here though because the company very graciously gifted me the Era bundle to try out, and here I use it kind of as a fine-tuning mechanism, like with Slick EQ. Just here to tweak things if there's a bit too much sibilance or too much de-essing. You could very much just crank the de-essing on the previous step, VX64, to kind of substitute for not having this guy. If you don't want him, go ahead and buy it. Next up, there's TDR Katelnikov, a really nice free compressor from the same people that did TDR Nova and Slick EQ. Crazy how useful this set of free plugins is. But compressors reduce the amplitude of the sound by a certain percent, that's the ratio, and once the volume exceeds the threshold. You see where both my exact values are for those settings. Feel free to tweak to get more or less leveling to your audio's volume. And I also brought the gain up on the out end, as compressing does effectively lower the volume of your entire audio. And last but not least, I like to pop a loud max onto the end of the chain, just to squash any leftover peaks. This definitely requires tuning to the audio track to make sure it's not too intense, yet still actually doing something. And on the out end, I set the max peak to -3 decibels. I do that so when I'm in video editing and I want to bring in background music or sound effects or something like that, I can do so without having the master volume just peak instantly because I brought something else in besides the voiceover track. But yeah, that's it for the chain itself. At this point in previous tutorials, I would have given y'all a chance to listen to the sound with all the effects applied, but of course here, that's what you've been listening to since I popped Loudmax on as the last effect. Guess it's time to show you how to install the plugins. So, the plugin lineup we need to download, the non-stock ones, are TDR Nova, Slick EQ, Katonikov, and Loudmax. Let's head to Tokyo Dawn Records real quick. Hold on now. Let's head to Tokyo Dawn Records to download these first three real quick. From the audio plugins page, you're going to open up, or I'm going to open up three different tabs for these three plugins. Got Nova first, Katonikov, and then Slick EQ. And from this point on, the process here is going to be the same for all three of these boys, considering they're made and distributed by the same people. So just do what I do here with Nova for the two other ones, Slick EQ and Katonikov. So scrolling down on the Nova page, there's going to be a download section a little bit below the comments. And what I'm going to go for here is the Windows version with the installer. So we're going to go ahead and download that to the default downloads folder. And I do want to apologize for the Mac people out there because I've never owned or extensively used a Mac. And so while I'm sure there's tutorials out there for installing these plugins on there, I personally can't be doing that. The most extensively I used a Mac was when I was doing dual credit classes, senior year of high school, and there was a computer lab of Macs that I would check my YouTube stats on ever so often. But back to what we're talking about, we got the download completed right now. We can click that file, and it opens up in the Windows Explorer because it's just a simple zip, and then run the executable. Run the executable that's in there. Gonna click yes to that. And then we can just start clicking through this little installer. I accept the agreement. Next, what we're going to do here is select which version of the plugin to install. And following that, it's going to ask where. Kickhawk works with every single one of these formats, so it's really a matter of picking which one you want to go with. I would say go with the 64-bit VST3 plugin. That's the latest version of the most universal plugin variety. And then we just click next, and here we're going to pick where you want to put that plugin. This is the important part. The previous word you want to install, that was installing the program. This is the actual location of the plugin. So here, we're going to navigate to Program Files, Cakewalk, and then VST Plugins. Click OK to that, and then Next. And then once we install with this location, we don't have to worry about going into Cakewalk or selecting the folder that we installed it to as a place to look for plugins, because this is a default folder. So we're just going to click install and wait for the magic to happen by itself. Got that finished screen. We are now good with TDR Nova, and you can just repeat this process with the two other Tokyo Dawn Records plugins. Now let's get Loudmax. We're going to look this guy up on Google. First thing is the Blogspot website that you can get Loudmax from. We're just going to select VST3 plugin with the version number for Windows PC 64-bit. Go download that boy. Wait for it to arrive in our files. Click on that. And then what you can see here is this is actually the file for the VST plugin as opposed to having an installer. And so what we're going to do is just copy this guy. Navigate to the folder we're just at, which is Program Files, Cakewalk, and VST Plugins. Just copy that guy, paste that guy into here. And then same thing should happen as should have happened with the previous plugin. It'll just show up in Cakewalk next time you open it. Or even if you already have it opened, I think when you pull it back up, it'll refresh. And the plugins will just be in there, sitting in Cakewalk, ready for you to use. So, now that we've run through the effect with the real-time examples for you guys, plus how to get the plugins, let's talk about this mic that I used as the guinea pig for the audio settings in this video. Not sure if you're evaluating how this guy sounded in and of itself, because obviously that wasn't really the focus of the video. It was making it sound good, making it sound voiceover ready with the edits. But this $30 budget USB mic has been pretty impressive, at least from the testing I've done so far. And it's time to jump into that sponsored video segment. Let's go. So yeah, the Toner TC30. If you played me raw audio from this mic without me already knowing what it was, I'd probably guess at the very least it costs 60 bucks or more, most likely standalone without extra equipment. But this guy's actually only 30 bucks, and it comes decked out with not just the mic itself, with a design I'm actually quite a fan of, but a stand with a mini shock and a pop filter as well. This is, of course, in addition to the USB-C cable, because this mic is USB plug and play, meaning there's effortless setup that literally takes just a few seconds. As far as sound quality goes, of course, the most important part, it sounds great as well. While compared to more expensive mics, the high frequencies aren't the cleanest, and the noise floor isn't perfect, I do admire that it holds its own against other mics in its league. I like how it doesn't have that metallic slash nasally undertone like the Snowball. This guy would definitely hold its weight for starting out YouTubers, streamers, or just people who want to up their quality in video calls. But overall, a great option for a cheap cardioid mic at $30. My name's Jason, hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you in the next one.